So I am live in front of Giant Eagle in Niles, and I have been refused services because I refuse. I'm allowed to shop in the store without a mask, but I'm not allowed to check out in the store without a mask. I don't know about you, America, but this is getting out of hand. First of all, a mandate is not the law, and they are trying to enforce mandates as the law, and I'm not gonna put up with it. I'm sorry if I stand alone. I stand alone. It's pretty sad and pathetic that people have been masking up for how many months now, and supposedly the numbers are rising. Really? The numbers are rising? The mandates are there and the numbers are rising? So if the masks work, you tell me why the numbers are rising. Doesn't make any sense. They're manipulating the numbers just like they're manipulating the polls and the ballots. And all of it. It's all a bunch of BS. And I freaking, for one, am so tired of it. And if you Americans do not stand up and start fighting for our freedoms, we are not going to have any freedoms left. It is pretty sad and pathetic that I am not able to go to a grocery store and shop because I'm not wearing a mask. The mask that every 99.9% of everybody's wearing, and supposedly the, sorry, I'm very, very angry right now. The percentage of people are going up, but guess what? People aren't dying from it anymore. It's called immunity, people. Probably if the numbers are legitimately going up, maybe it could possibly be because there's no immunity taking place anymore. There's no herd immunity. Our immune systems are totally destroyed from masking up everywhere we go. I am so fed up with this. And if I don't know why people are just doing what they're told and not fighting back. This is literally our last attempt to fight back. If we do not fight now, we will never have a chance again to fight back. I will be calling 21 News and I'm going to be complaining about being refused a service at Giant Eagle on Ni in Niles for not wearing a mask. It is a mandate. It is not a law. It hasn't gone through the courts to be made a law yet. And if it ever becomes a law, we are in big trouble because if they can enforce that upon us, they can enforce anything upon us. We seriously need to start standing up for this country. I am so amazed at how 99% of you go do exactly what you're told. You know what they're doing? They're basically trying to find out who's going to be obedient and who needs to be put into submission. I will not be put into submission. I will not be put into submission. I'm not submitting to something that is not the law, something that has proven to not work. Like I said, if the mask worked like they say they did, guess what? The numbers would not be going up because 99.9% of people are doing exactly what they're telling you to do because you guys are all sheep. There's a bunch of sheep. I don't give a crap who gets mad at me. I freaking don't care anymore. Get mad, disagree. I don't care. But the fact of the matter is this: we are losing our country and we are losing our freedoms when you cannot go into a grocery store without wearing a mask and you get refused service. We are in serious trouble as a nation, and our freedoms are at stake. So, I would recommend that every single one of you stand up. When DeWine tries to shut us down, you better not shut your business down because I'm telling you, they want to shut us down for 4 to 6 weeks. In 4 to 6 weeks, we will no longer be able to recover economically. So what's going to happen? We're going to all be relying on our government. And what a way to control. It's all a plan that they have. They want us to be reliant on the government for everything. And people are just eating it up and they're believing it. Well, I'm not believing it. I'm not accepting it. And I'm freaking over it. I am so sick of this coronavirus. I'm so sick of the lies that they keep feeding us. And I'm very sick of the American people that continue to do what they're told to do and not stand up and fight for their country and their freedoms. I feel so alone anymore. Like I'm the only freaking one out there fighting. And I will continue the fight and I will continue not submitting to the things that are mandated that are not the freaking law until we win and we're successful. Because I'm telling you, America, if we don't stand up and fight now, this is our last chance to ever fight for our liberty and freedoms. If we lose to Biden and we don't fight for our election and we don't fight for all these stupid mandates, we will never have the opportunity again. We will be just like China. We'll be communist country and we will be told what to do, when to do it, where to go. We will be given monthly checks. I know a lot of you think that's all. Yes, I want to have a monthly check. I want to be freaking lazy. No, I want to stay in the country where you have capitalism and you can work hard and you can make whatever kind of money you want. I don't want to sit around and wait for the government to give me money. I'm sorry, that's not how I was born and raised. I want to work for what I have, and I have worked for what I have, and I do not want anything from the government. I want nothing from the government. All I want them to do is stay out of my life. That's what I want from the government. Stay out of our lives and let us do what we want. If somebody wants to wear a mask, by all means, if you feel safer and you're high risk, wear the freaking mask. That's fine. Do it. But don't tell me that I have to do it. That's when you're stepping over the lines and you are infringing on my freedoms. And guess what? What was yesterday? Veterans Day, where we celebrated the people that fought for our liberties and our freedoms. And that is one of the reasons why I will continue this fight every single day, because they are not, their fight was not in vain. We got to continue the fight, people. I am sorry, but I am so riled up. I never thought there would be a day in America that you can't go into a store and you will be declined service because you don't wear a mask. That is not the law, that it's a mandate. So people, seriously, stand up. Like, stand up and fight for your freedoms. If you love your freedoms, stand up, because they're rapidly being taken away, and everybody put their little mask on and go do their thing, and they don't even fight for their freedoms. Well, I'm sorry, I must be made from a different cut, because I'll be darned if I'm going to sit there and let them mandate to me what I can and cannot do and what I will and will not wear. Sorry, not happening. We better pray. If you are a Christian, you better pray to God every day that Biden does not get elected and that Trump, this thing gets overruled from all the cheating that's taken place. And that's exactly what they did. They knew they couldn't win without the mail-in ballots, and that's why we had the mail-in ballots. And if they end up winning, and they I don't think they will, but if they do, bye-bye America without a fight. Bye-bye America. So stand up and fight for your rights, people, because I am tired of fighting alone. Have a great day. This is almost